journeys make Tora tired.
Refresh and set off again.
Okay, bring it on.
Poppy cutie, I'll bring it. Nice
one. Maybe we'll get out.
Like your attitude.
Scatter shot. Quick
and hard. Please leave my door.
Do you want to show them?
Maybe we're not.
Show that job. Everyone's getting excited.
Did you throw the
radius?
Floren, is something up with that tree?
This one. She's hurt.
Hurt?
Yeah. She got injured when we were fighting those guys back there.
Yeah, but it's a tree. They patch themselves up, don't they?
They're living creatures, Nia. If we just leave her like this, she might wither and die. You can't joke about that.
Sorry. I didn't mean to insult the tree.
But even if tree hurt, what can we do about it?
Can we heal it?
I don't know. I'll have to do some research. Maybe if we find the right kind of medicine.
Medicine? If it exists, I'm sure the rest of us can help track it down.
Then it's decided. Let's heal the tree.
Really? You'll help me?
I guess there are some people that'll be pretty cut up if this tree died. Community service of a sort.
You don't mind us pitching in, do you?
Not at all. Thank you, everyone. Right. Let's see what we can learn about her. I understand now. To heal her, we're going to need fungicide, an antidesiccant. We could also use a tree brace to keep her steady while she's healing.
So all we need to heal the tree is those three things?
Yep.
Then what are we waiting for?
Where exactly are we going to find all that stuff, though?
Kedwin lives in Torrigoth in Gormot, knows much about tree plants.
Good thinking, Tora. I'm sure he can help.
Meh.
Right. Let's go talk to Kedwin.
Yeah. We'll come back as quickly as we can. Please hold on a little longer.
Journeys make Tora tired.
Refresh and set off again.
Come out, come out.
Flora heals an aching
soul. Please open your hearts to me.
Thank you.
Let's get going!
Up!
Refresh and set off again.
What have we here?
The forest really calms your
searching
spirit.
Searching database.
Refresh and set off again.
See, Gramps? I'm getting better.
There is still much to learn.
Good morning. I hope I didn't snore or anything.
Ugh, I slept like a baby.
Where you?
Let us go.
What have we here?
Let us go.
We're here.
Let's get going.
Journeys make Dora tired.
Refresh.
What have we here?
Maybe agriculture is Poppy's specialist field.
What have we here?
Maybe agriculture is Poppy's specialist field. Sorry to keep you waiting. We'll make you all better.
How's it going? Is it working?
Yes, it's okay. She should be back to her old self in no time.
That's great. I guess our work here is done.
Nice one, Floren.
Thank you. And I'm sure the tree would thank you as well if she could.
Even though it's just a tree, I hope it knows that everything is okay now.
Of course she does. She's just as aware as we are.
What a world, eh? You learn something every day. Thank you, Floren.
You're welcome.
If they seek a fight, they shall get one.
Small fry!
This'll be over before we get
caught.
You got me.
Thank you.
Come out, come out.
And set off again.
Excellent. Looks like we were just in time.
I wonder if the other trees are okay.
Come out, come out.
It's all okay now.
A timely intervention.
See if the other trees are okay.
Mehmet, off we go.
Refresh and set off again.
Thank you.
Nothing to worry about now.
We only just made it.
I'm not sure about the other trees. I wonder if they're okay.
We're here.
Let's get going.
What have we here?
The forest really calms your spirit.
Searching database.
New enemy in the middle of the road.
All right,
Too. I wouldn't have been able to save the tree without my friends helping out. Some people may not care about the environment, but there are loads of people who do.
I'm in the second camp. This tree means a lot to me.
Me too. It's the most cherished thing we have here.
That's wonderful. Please don't change that way of thinking.
We promise not to, miss.
Just so you know, I'm not a miss. I'm a mister.
What?
Huh? You mean you didn't know? You must have known, right?
I'll keep on at it.
I get more captivating by the minute.
Best of luck, guys.
I'll take care of it.
Stepping up to the plate. Say the word.
Best of luck to you.
Watch your mouth.
I vow to carry out my sworn duty.
Let us rake in the assets.
Don't forget who's boss. Do what I say, you'll be fine.
Just show me the way.
Come out, come out.
The forest really calms
Searching
your spirit.
Searching database.
Let's rest a spell.
Let's get going.
What have we here?
The forest really calms your
spirit. Searching database. Right, Floren. What's that?
The land is choked with sand. Is this really Elysium? No flowers, no trees, no grass. Just a barren plain of rocks and sand. Look! I bet that was a beautiful lake once. But there isn't even a drop of water left.
I suppose they don't get much rain here.
Water is essential for life. But there isn't any here. This place is completely barren. Some places have a drought now and again, but they still have a little hope. This place, it's just dead.
There must be some way to bring back the greenery.
No roots can take hold in sand like this, and nothing is going to grow without water. Wait! Maybe something can grow. Well, you know life is a powerful thing. It may be too dry for seeds here, but
we could get some seedlings from somewhere else and plant them here.
Yes! At first, they probably won't last very long. But as plants die, their remains fertilize the soil. They'll be giving their goodness back to the next generations. it will take a while, but do it enough times, and eventually, this dead land can be restored to life.
That's more like the Floren I know.
Yes, thank you. I'm going to do it. I'm going to bring back the vegetation.
Let's rest a spell.
Let's get going.
Oh.
Hey Zeke, Pandoria, you got a moment?
Sure, what's up? You're not usually the type to start a serious discussion.
Well, you see, it's about Turtus.
Turtus?
Sorry, but Turtus is our mascot. I know he's the cutest little chap in the world, but you can't have him.
You heard the prince. If you ask nicely, we might allow you to pat him on the head.
Uh-huh. Thanks for confirming what I already guessed. You haven't even noticed, have you? He's been crawling into my bed every night.
He's been what?
If I'm not super careful, I worry I'm going to crush the little guy in my sleep. But like you say, he's your precious little mascot, eh? I figured you'd be mad if I owed him. So he's been keeping me awake the whole damn night.
Well, I guess I should apologize on Turtus' behalf.
Honestly, weren't you meant to be keeping an eye on him?
Well, you know me. Once my head hits the sheets, I'm out for the count.
We'd better find a way to stop him wandering off.
He could sleep in my bed.
Yeah, that might be the best solution.
He used to sleep in my bed back in the day anyway. It'll be fine.
I guess that settles it. Thanks, Pandoria.
You can count on me.
Hang on, though. You said he used to sleep in your bed back in the day. Just how long have you had this turtle?
Oh, it hasn't been as long as me and old Princey here, but it's been quite a while, I think.
Huh. It's just that he's so small. I always assumed he was pretty young. So what would you do if you grew up to be Dromark-sized?
The things that go through that head of yours.
Watch it, you.
He wouldn't be quite so portable if that were to happen.
Right? It got me wondering, would you guys stick together even then?
Why, I could ride around on top of Tertus instead.
You mean like Nia and Dromark?
Yeah, that sounds pretty sweet, right?
You'd probably get left behind. A lot.
And how?
Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna be glad that Tertus stayed this size.
Journeys make Tora tired.
Refresh and set off again.
Absent.
A shame. You were hoping to meet him again, weren't you?
It feels a little strange for me to think of it as again, but I did wish to meet with him, yes.
I remember the old you, standing tranquilly beside the throne. Quiet and resolved.
I can sense it is a good memory for you.
I had hoped some memory might linger within you too, but alas, it seems not.
So it would appear. Unlike you, Bridget, I did not have past records to fall back on. Without any data, it is difficult to feel any emotional connection either.
And now you're prohibited from reading those records that do exist as well.
So I am. So I am. Therefore, I know not what I have been doing, nor what my role is in the Ardanian Empire. I can comprehend some of it by talking with you or Morag, but I feel sure there is much of importance I do not grasp. Hence my plan, to ask Emperor Nile why it was that he forbade me from reading the past records.
Do you have any idea what the reason might be?
I wonder. From what I hear, it seems I failed to keep the Emperor safe, yes? In which case, might it not mean I have been relieved of the duty to protect His Majesty?
That's very pessimistic. You always are too hard on yourself, Aegeon. I think Emperor Niall was hoping you would protect Allrest, and not just him. Rather than keep someone as excellent as you cooped up in Moradane, he preferred to have you contribute to the well-being of the world at large.
I see. He thought my knowing my past role in Moradane would hinder that.
That's what I think.
I see. I may not have been able to meet the Emperor, but just talking to you, Bridget, has given me strength.
Always glad to help. For what it's worth, I can't wait for the day when you're back by the side of the throne.
Are you worried for him?
Maybe somewhat. Anyone can aid the Emperor in his duties, but to keep him safe takes someone truly special. Up until now, I felt secure knowing that His Majesty was protected by myself, Lady Morag, and you.
Certainly. The sooner things fall back into place, the better. When all is said and done, I will return to the throne room. You and me both, Bridget. We will help see this through.
Right. I'll be counting on you.
Journeys make Dora tired.
Refresh and set off again.
There's no reason I should recognize this place. So what is this I feel? This tugging in my breast. I can't shake this sense of...
Vess? You're Vess, aren't you? So you've come back?
Thought he'd be so happy.
Who might you be?
Huh?
What are you talking about? Don't you recognize us?
Vess has not got memories from before.
I see. So Vess's memories got wiped after Daddy passed away.
And so, you're her new driver now.
Right.
You could say the old man left it to us.
Well then, it's a relief that her new driver's a nice person.
It's nice. Daddy would be happy knowing you're taking care of her.
You belong to this household, right?
This is the house our daddy used to live in. But just the other day, he moved on from this life.
We haven't been back in a while, but we needed to make arrangements.
Ah, I see. I'm sorry for your loss. Can I help you in any way?
No, but I really appreciate you saying that. May I ask though, why did you come here?
That's... I couldn't really tell you. But when I saw this house, I felt a warm wash of nostalgia.
Is that right?
I think whoever lived here must have been a great person.
Why'd you say that?
Well, I know it from looking at you two. After all, he raised a pair of wonderful children like you. It's the sure mark of a great person.
No, that daddy was just a regular guy. The real great person here was the one who raised us after our ma died.
Kinder and warmer than ma ever was.
Where is that person now?
Taking care of important business, I hear. But we hope to meet them again, once that's done. We'll have so much to talk about.
I see. Well, I think that's good. I'm sure they'll be happy to. I can help out more now.
This'll prove invaluable on our quest.
That was a slog.
Let us go.
Meh! Morning already?
It a new